Hello everyone, and welcome back to a new episode of Dungeon Crawl Stone Soup. We're playing this Formicid Ice Elementalist of Kybriados for not a week anything. I'm going to do this so many times. I hope you guys like hearing me say week and then change my mind for Crawl 0.18 release tournament. I could go back and edit these, right? I could, but... Or I could just cut the video and start over. But I don't know. I think it's fun for you guys to hear that, like, I have no idea what games I'm even playing. How many people have won this so far? Two? One? Come on, tell me, bot. Please tell me. I typed in the thing, it just takes a while. Two wins. We are in first place of the remaining players. Okay. Great. So, depths 5, here we come. Pretty favorable layout, I would say. Oops! I figured that was the boundary of the, I don't know, for some reason I just figured we could make this into a kill hole, but this is fine, actually. It's a golden dragon, I would love to chop him up. Did he leave a corpse? No. Lame. What is this amulet? Whoa, amulet of bloodlust. Huh. No thanks. Well, maybe. I mean, obviously the rage stuff is not relevant. So it'd be like an amulet of magic resistance plus slay, basically. The strength and it are like roughly interchangeable to me. Hmm. Interesting that Kybriados doesn't like it. I mean, like, if I don't use the rage effects, it shouldn't bother him, but I don't know. I just won't worry about it. It's not a big improvement anyway. Like, reflection is pretty good when we have this much shield. Normally, I'm not a huge fan of reflection, but I do like it when we have a lot of shields. It improves, like, I mean, the main advantage of shield is that you don't get hit by stuff. But also, if stuff just spontaneously dies, like, that's pretty good. Right? I think so. A bunch of Spriggans are really no concern at all. Is the Enchantress around here, or was it just them by themselves? What is this layout like? We have 5 scrolls of mapping? I'll save these for Zot. It's not important that I know what this layout looks like, really. Okay, this looks very suspicious. Yeah, let's leave this for later. It looks very suspicious. No, I don't have to go the way that we're supposed to go. I can just dig through the walls. What is this? I'll just make my own way through there. There's Abyss, a ring, which we, like, almost can't care about. Yeah. All right, just checking, that is not a room. I just want to, like, know... I want to have, like, kill holes everywhere in case I need them. Book of Power. Still has Iron Shot. But we seem to have gone in the direction of summoning. Yeah. We could forget Chikima's Dance, too. Ooh. It's not that good. Well, actually, it is better than our Ring of Protection from Magic, so there we go. We can drop that now. What is all this? This is also vaulty. But I'm guessing more like Abyss or Pan than Zot. Hell, okay. Wonder why that's hell. Weird shape. Boy, that fight in Hanged Man Pleasure Drome's last episode, right? The The Juggernauts, it was all horrible. We used like 5 or 6 slouches on that stuff. And then it was still not solved. I'm just remembering it with like sadness. So I checked, I already told you guys how we're doing in the race. I don't know, it just was on my mind all of a sudden. But I've told you, so you don't care to be told again. Yeah, this is a big, scary vault of some kind. Clearly, in my opinion, the entrance to Zot. Yeah, here's the Draconians, so let's just back off. We should be able to, like, absolutely ruin any Draconians. Oh, he's a caller, huh? Yeah, how about you get abjured? How do you like that? Let's back up, though. Oh, he blew up my thing! Rude! My kill hole! Stupid Deep Elf Earth Mage. Let's make a new one. This one's not as conveniently placed. I'm engulfed in poison gas. Also rude. Well, whatever. I guess we're just gonna have to put up with it. Shadow dragons. Can we get some gold dragons up in here, please? Why is this guy just staying there? Why is he not flying over to us? Why can a black draconian not fly? Really? Player black draconians can fly. Maybe a stone giant will do something to him. I don't know. Let's just AB our way out of that cloud. I need to do something about the summoner. I don't know, I guess I'll just leave. Abjure those guys. Super badly poisoned, but it's fine. Let's just exclude these guys and leave them alone, I guess. Level 26, we're almost up there, up to 27. And let's exclude these as well. Lich, no big problem. Invocation's 13, 14 is about where I would be happy. Oh, hello, Juggernaut. he's down there. Shadow Creatures creates one Ice Dragon. Underwhelming is my review. The second Shadow Creatures looks pretty good, though. Let's try another one. Yeah, cool. Killed the Juggernaut. Good work. All right, that's depths all cleared out. And that means it's probably time to go to slime. Yeah, slime seems fine. I don't really feel like curing out of this stuff. Those remutes are fine. We have our sweet corrosion resistance and RC++ for slime as well. Yeah, I guess there's not much for it, but just go. And that was a pretty short, yeah, we don't want to have a 10-minute long video, so we'll do slime this video as well. Slime is pretty fast, so it shouldn't be a big problem. Yeah, die. And let's eat just some bread or something. There's still some stuff in depths, but mostly it's all clear. And slime. I have a lot of practice in slime. I should be okay, but being slow is a problem. Alright, what are we dropping out here? This. So let's review my Ring of Ice. What ice spells am I casting now? Sometimes Ice Beast, but not even very often. So you know what? Let's forget that too. Let's drop the Ring of Ice. And switch to something a little bit more versatile. Like this ring, capital J, that I'm planning to take to slime is like a much better Ring of Ice if you're not casting ice spells. Not gonna need our Wand of Acid, Ring of Poison Resistance. Invisibility doesn't help much down there. It's hard to imagine wanting flight, but I guess so. If I used a File of Floods, I might want flight. Scroll of Holy Word. Magic Mapping. Alright, that should do. Put on the Ring capital J. Put on the Ring F. Drop the Ring K. There's a porcupine attacking me. Hello. Let's make sure we have on all the jewelry we wanted. Yeah. Okay. Very good cold resist. Pretty solid magic resist. Corrosion resist. Don't need fire resist down in slime. So I reported, like, it would be a little bit of an overstatement to say that I reported a bug that black draconians can't fly, but I did mention it. So hopefully someone will fix that. And if not, maybe I'll have to. But it's sort of in some stuff that I don't want to try to figure out. A lot of slime creatures. We should stare dance this stuff. Fighting them out in the open here, they're pretty harmless. And in particular, when there aren't more of them closing in on me at all times. Yeah. Golden eyes, like, are just not a big problem for this character. They might confuse me, but it's pretty hard. And the great orbs of eyes, similarly. Jesus, would you stop blinking around? Normally, for most characters, like, the paralysis and the confusion are... Or the paralysis, anyway, is a big problem. The confusion, maybe not. But anyway, for us, we're resisting most stuff, so that's fine. Having three pips of magic resistance really helps. Alright, two acid blobs, that's a lot. Let's go upstairs. Regen, rest. Downstairs. Carry this acid blob upstairs, so we are only ever fighting one of them at a time. What are we working on here? Mazes and flails and invocations. That seems okay. Oh, and dodging. Yeah, seems fine. I feel like I could use some more fighting soon. Alright, we grab the acid blob. Let's take him upstairs. Cool. Azure Jelly, no problem with RC++. We're just going to dive slime like I always do. Hello, Dissolution. Have I ever killed Dissolution? I know I've seen him once, but I'm not sure I've ever killed him. I have killed him twice. Once on my Gargoyle Monk, that was like my real-time speedrun, and once on my Naga Warper of Kybriados. I don't even remember doing that. Alright. He summons eyeballs, which for many, many characters is horrifying. Because of the paralysis. But for us, it's not that big a deal, I don't think. Let's just, make some shadow creatures. Like, he can abjure them, but, actually, let's start an abjuration ourselves. We have one jelly. Wow. Very impressive. Slow him down. That'll help a lot. Yeah, see you later. Shining Eye, I'm not a fan of. I just want to keep some monsters in between me and it. Wow, they actually killed it. Great. That's better than I expected. Oh, all three upstairs are right here. Interesting. All right. I thought one of those must be a downstairs, like, despite all evidence. All right, two acid blobs at once is scary, so let's bend time. Let's make sure we're regenerating. And we'll keep an eye on deflect missiles. Although, since they're adjacent to me, their missiles are not the biggest concern. But they still do shoot missiles at you sometimes, and it's nice to block those. All right, there go the acid blobs. Fine. Great. Eat some bread. Regen downstairs. Please, Shining Eye right here. Is there anything I can do to, like, get a monster between me and him immediately? Not really. I don't need another Shining Eye. All right, well, we'll just cure out of this stuff soon. Yeah, there he goes. Another one. Down he goes. Regen, head down to slime 5, head down to slime 6. We're there. We're in. Okay, great. So we want to approach the Royal Jelly with caution. Preferably quietly, but we're hitting things so hard that that's not too likely. I often like to sort of clear out the level before I go in after the Royal Jelly. But I'm not really sure why. I think it's mostly for teleports, which I can't do anyway as a Formicid, so I think I'll just go in to make sure I keep the element of surprise in as much as possible. Let's just regen. This should be an acid blob, right? Yeah, okay. Yeah, stuff is hearing me and coming up here. Which I don't like, but what can you do? There's the Royal Jelly. Ugh. And since I'm a Formicid, I can't... So you really want to fight him in a corridor. In, like, I want to be standing here or something, right? So that the jellies he spawns don't have room to attack you. Or even sometimes to spawn. And normally, when the Royal Jelly appears before I'm ready for him, I just teleport, and then I come back later. But I can't do that. We have plenty of agility, might, and brilliance, which are all great things to have when you're fighting the Royal Jelly. There's some argument for drinking the agility early, because I sort of anticipate the Royal Jelly making it hard to avoid this fight, right? Like, it's impossible for me to avoid this fight, except with, say, Step from Time, which I could do. I kind of like the idea of doing that. Clear out whatever I have to, as much as I can, before the Royal Jelly arrives, and then Step from Time to reset the fight. That seems fine. Which one's the Royal Jelly? He's way back there. Okay. Paralyzed. Wow, my giant eyeball really can paralyze slime creatures. All right, now the Royal Jelly is right on top of me, and I don't want to fight him. I don't want that to happen. Do I have any friendlies who are going to attack the Royal Jelly? No. So that's good. I don't want them to make him spawn more guys. So we're just going to step from time right now. He's still right here. Interesting. Well, let's just quaff the agility, I suppose. AA to slow him. He resists. AA again. He easily resists. All right, well, let's just walk in here then. Quaff, now that we're ready to start fighting, might summon some shadow creatures to fill in the slots here. Death Ooze and Acid Blob. Jeez, this is a mess. I don't know about this. Oh, let's regen, huh? Well, jeez. No, let's not. I need to save the MP for Step in case I need that. Why am I sick? What? Oh, Death Ooze, I guess? Yeah, must be. I didn't even know they did that. All right, we got him. The situation is not great. But it's okay. If we can kill this one acid blob, we'll have like a break from... What do we want to kill? Like, I want to have one side of me not be surrounded by enemies, right? If I attack north, I can kill that acid blob, and then there's like some buffer of these slime creatures between me and the approaching horde of that stuff. If I attack south, more stuff is just going to fill in, I think, for a while. So I think I'll just attack north. It's the obvious thing, and I can't see any reason why it's wrong. Well, one reason is that the slime creatures are not going to last long. I thought they might last long enough to make a difference, but it looks like no. Another thing we could do is spend a turn or two digging up to here, create a proper kill hole. I'm a little bit concerned about walking right now, but I think it's the thing to do. Yeah, that's a big improvement. It was a little bit risky, but it went fine. Now I can regen comfortably. And I think we have this well in hand. Yeah, especially getting the vampiric draining from attacking these guys. With might and agility, they don't stand a chance. Agility is gone, and might, I presume, will be gone pretty soon as well, but it's fine. Get pummeled, you stupid shining eye. Oh man, repel missiles has been off for a while. It's always a Royal Jelly. The fight is the same in a lot of games. Maybe, you know, not every game. Like in this one, there are always like some twists, right? Like in this game, the twist was I couldn't really reposition. I had to fight him before I wanted to. But it's sort of similar all the time. All the same, though. How many scrolls have I not found? All the same, it's like a relief when it's done, because you are in pretty bad shape the way you have to fight him sometimes. I don't know. I mean, you're in, like, okay shape. In that when you do things carefully, he's not, like, summoning a ton of stuff, but it's still a strong enemy. I don't know. I always worry a little. Give me this. Let's see what it is. Wow. Yes, I accept. It's like the cloak. Oops, I just dropped it. Get it back. Wear it. Yep. Drop the old cloak. F. New amulet. Pick it up. What is it? Dreadful. Get out of here, you stupid amulet. New book. Oh, and a new ring. Grand Grimoire. That's pretty cool. This is terrible. But we could learn, like, summon horrible things that could be in our future. It's not too far off. Monstrous Menagerie is also decent, but I think I'd rather have shadow creatures, honestly. Let's go back to, I don't know, summonings. Turn off maces and flails. Turn on fighting. Sure. Book of Ice. Could learn Simulacrum if we wanted to, but I don't really. Come get me, you shining eye. I dare you. Any of this loot any good? New book. Mutagenic Conjuration, huh? Sting, Passwall, and Dragon Form. What a strange collection of books. I wouldn't call it Mutagenic Conjuration. The only conjuration is Sting, which hardly even counts, but okay, I guess. And Mutagenic? Sure, I guess. Alright, we're just gonna leave. And we rotted a tiny bit, but it's no big deal at all. Our defenses are starting to be quite respectable as well. Now that we've got the plate sort of in hand. What of this do we need to pick back up? Well, the protection from fire and the protection from poison are pretty good. The wand of acid is pretty good. The scrolls are good. Potion's good. What do we want to drop? I want to put on my ring of protection from fire instead of capital J, I think. Yeah, good resists now. Drop, I don't know, this stuff is all fine. Oh, we're getting close to the end of the game, guys. Just Zot left at this point, and the orb run. I don't think I'll be diving Zot this game. We're probably going to clear it, so it'll be a video or two. Not the sort of super quick diving affair that I often go for. As a former Sith of Kyriados, you really are great at murdering things and not so great at dodging slash avoiding things. So that's what I'm going to do. Anyway, that's in the next video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next.